Hi students, in this video we are going to see about important topic is steam. Okay, in the first module we are discussing about the sources of energy, and the already we have seen the thermodynamic properties. What are they, what is the thermodynamics, and what are the laws of thermodynamics, and what is the heat, enthalpy, entropy and all. So now we are going to see further the thermodynamical properties of steam, and here we are going to discuss in this chapter, in this topic, steam. Okay, we know what is a steam. Okay, steam is how it is created, all the things we have seen, and what is the use of steam. These are all the things now we are going to see. So steam is a water in a gaseous stage, that's it. So when the water is getting heated up, the heat, water, it gets the heat and it's converted into another stage. So stage by stage the water is getting heated up, and the water is converted into a invisible stage. That's a saturated or superheated, is an invisible stage. So here you can say wet steam, dry steam and superheated steam. Three different types of steams are we are going to study. So visible mist and invisible gases, all the things are coming, we are going to cover here. So formation of steam at a constant pressure. Okay, so this image, what we are going to see here is a steam, how it is getting formed, and what are the temperature sources it is required, all the things we are going to see here. So in this video we can see first a cylinder with some volume of water. Imagine a water at 0 degree. The first A, if you see that, imagine water at 0 degree is there, and over that a piston, and with the work W, a load is there. Okay, I am giving heat. The volume V, it's there. So when I am heating the thing, the water at 0 degree, it's just started to boil. Okay, slightly it is going to be started. So, and that is a VF, volume of liquid, it is getting increases. You can see the volume is getting increases when the heat is added up. After that, again, still if you are giving heat, some portion of water is going to be vapor and remaining water is water. So that is when again there is a changes of phase takes place from water to vapor, it is going to be changing, taking place, but completely at a sudden it's not going to be changed. So little bit, little the water is going to be converted. Okay, that is things is happening, and at one stage it becomes totally vapor, sorry, steam, that's vapor, water particles, right? So that in the D sketch you can see when further heat is added up, volume is increases, and the dry steam at some temperature, that is saturated temperature we call it as. Normally what for water it is 100 degree centigrade, right? So water totally it is getting boiled, and the temperature at the particular temperature, still I am adding heat, what will happen? That will become superheated steam. So a water directly it will not be converted into steam, a stage by stage it is getting converted. So in this sketch we can see that one. So first of all, imagine that water is at 0 degree temperature at a point A. Here the A, B, C, D, it explains the temperature and the enthalpy diagram. So enthalpy is a H and T is at the temperature in the vertical column. So 0 degree water is there, and we are adding some heat. So the liquid region water is getting evaporating until to a situation, that is T saturation. When it reaches B, the water is heated up and it starts to boil, and from B to C vaporization takes place. That is when further I am giving heat, that the enthalpy, I am giving enthalpy, that is the heat is taken place by from B to C, the water is vaporizing, but the at the same temperature. From 100 degree of water is converted into 100 degree of temperature vapor at the C. So then again I am giving heat. Okay, that is a superheated area. We are giving further heat. The 100 degree of steam is converted into high level of steam. Temperature is increases, but steam is also converting into high steam, superheated steam. So this is how the steam is getting generated from water to a superheated steam. So why superheated steam is needed and all the things we will see here next. So in any case, states of steam or three different states, as I said, wet steam, dry steam, superheated. So once we know that water is converted into steam at after 100 degree, that's we know that only everything is converted into steam, but there are different stages of steam over there. First stage is wet steam, there where the water particle is mixed with the steam, so some amount of water is the molecules will be there, that is called wet steam. If some heat is added up to the wet steam, then slowly the water particles in the steam is getting vaporized. So a dry steam at a level, in the first case we have seen the point, see, a dry steam is getting formed. Okay, first wet steam from the point B to C, so water is getting vaporizing, slowly getting vaporizing. So a liquid plus vapor mixer is there in this in between. So later from B to C, first B is some liquid form of 100 degree of water, and it is C is 100 degree of temperature gas steam. So it's a conversion from one point to another point, it takes place slowly. So the dry steam is at point C, it is totally having no water particles. So superheated steam is one, which is another kind when further the steam is getting heated up beyond the dry state temperature, higher than the temperature, saturated temperature, is a, we can see the superheated temperature, right? So the dryness fraction of the steam, how it depends upon the wet steam has a different proportion of water. Already we have seen wet steam in the sense it has some water particles. Dry steam is there is no water particle at all. Okay, in between that, how we know what level of the steam is, if there is more water or less water, how we know, and is there water or not, how we know. So to find this, we are going to find a dryness fraction. The dryness fraction called x, we are going to design a notation called x. So this x value, if it is equal to 1, okay, the dryness fraction is 1, then it is a fully dry steam. If the dryness fraction is less than 1 and it is, which is equal to 0, 0 to 1, there is some water molecules in the steam, okay, that is called a wet steam. This is how we can quantify, we can measure the, we can tell about the quantity or quality of the water. So the ratio of mass of the dry steam in a given quantity of wet steam to the total mass of the wet steam, this is called the x. So defined as the ratio of mass of dry steam is equal to mg, mass of mf is equal to mass of water molecules. So x is equal to mg divided by mg plus mf. The dryness fraction of wet steam is 1, less than 1, dryness of I said no, x is equal to 1 means it is totally fully dry steam. If x is equal to less than 1, then it is the wet steam. Okay, so here in this case of any one problem, you will see a problem it determine the dryness fraction of a steam which has 1.5 kg of water in suspension with 50 kg of steam. So the what is the data given is mass of the water particle mf, okay, that is 1.5 kg. Mass of the dry steam which is given is 50 kg. So the formula to find this x dryness fraction is mg divided by mf plus mg. So mass of the dry steam 50 divided by 1.5 kg of water plus 50 kg of steam, which is equal to, we will get 0.97. So when the dryness fraction is 0.97, then it is absolutely, it is a wet steam only. The dryness fraction is 0.97. Like that, another problem, 8 kg of wet steam contain 1.56 of water particle. What is the dryness fraction of the steam? Okay, so here the data given is mass of the wet steam is what, 8 kg of wet steam. So mass of the wet steam is 8 kg. Mass of the water particle mf, that is 1.56. so what we need is dryness, mass of the dry steam present is totally, wet steam is 8 kg and wet steam water particle is 1.56, means we can minus it, we will get the dryness dry steam, that is 6.44 kg, that is mg. So mg we know, mf we know, by using this we can find the x value, which is mg divided by mf plus mg. 0.805. We will get the dryness fraction 0.805. So the by using the dryness fraction, we can come to know whether it is a wet steam or dry steam. So this is what how we are going to find this wet steam dryness fractions and all. Okay.